Why do some drugs are acceptable to some countries but not to others? Historical context: the present legal and social frameworks are greatly influenced by the present state doping policies. Historical evolution: the example lends itself, as if the case of opium, which was used quite freely for the medical purposes in the 19th century, only to be followed with stricter laws, especially in the Western countries after the opium wars and the treaties that followed. Certain Asian countries, of the other hand, have a more relaxed approach nowadays, as they have always practiced traditional medicine, which included opium. Cultural attitudes. Cultural perspective regarding drugs are based on archetypes and beliefs within the community. Some societies have a history of using certain substances, such as marijuana, for social practices or religious ceremonies, which alters the legislation concerning such practices. For example, in India, cannabis has been used in religious rituals and traditional medicine for many centuries, and so more lenient laws have come about despite the global campaign for stricter cannabis laws. Conversely, drug use among Western countries has long retained a stigma and association with delinquent behaviors. Despite the growing acceptance of drug discriminations in recent years. Political influence. Drug legislation is political in nature, since the subject tends to mirror the ambitions and ideologies of those in power. Given the centrality of national politics, it is possible, for instance, to have an oppressive penal code in one country and a human policy that emphasizes harm minimization in other country. It is to be noted, however, that measures such as the Single Convention of Narcotic Drugs in most cases has ensured the drug policies in member countries are even more similar. Political considerations also affect the arbitrary and the disproportionate applications of drug laws, which often focused on economically driven religion.
Number 4, public health. Approaches, forums of public health regarding drug usage do not treat drug use as a crime, but rather as a health problem with a focus on reducing risk and improving population health. Such an approach is common in countries where drug possession is decriminalized and harm reduction strategies are implemented. For instance, drug-related deaths and HIV infections rates in Portugal, which has decriminalized all drugs since 2001, are known to be very low. This underlines the need to take measures to include drug abuse in public health. Number 5, economic factors. The influence of drug policy is also determined by the economics involved in the manufacture, trade, and regulation of drugs, owing to their potential large economic effects. Some drugs are grown and marketed in these countries, like cannabis in Morocco and Afghanistan, for instance, because they are sagging sources of income. This makes it possible for the economy to expand and for there to be stable income by making these industries legal and managing them. In addition, Some countries have shifted toward such approaches in order to minimize expenditures on law enforcement and earn money through taxes instead.
Now, here is the example of drugs. Drug abuse is the overindulgence in attacking mankind with psychoactive substances for non-medical purposes. Example, cannabis, or also called marijuana. There are numerous arguments surrounding the application of cannabis for non-medical uses. Since ancient times, cultures across the globe have ingested cannabis in moderation for medical or recreational reasons or for spiritual practices. In ancient India, for instance, cannabis was utilized as a drug and medicine, breaking the law in a number of other places. On the other hand, in the early 20th century, and the most heightened expectation Western societies, which have been influenced by treaties and dry movement, were out to prohibit any use of cannabis as it was seen as a menacing substance. These and other culture history account differences affect the ways in which the current populations perceive drugs or drug use and further inform the policies about drugs. In the Philippines, the sales and consumption of drug is generally intolerable as it is highly regulated and there is prohibition on a number of such substances. There is a strict no use, no possess, no trafficking approach to illegal substances. So there are almost no drug dealers or users in this country. This is mainly because of the government's incorporated approach toward the issue of drug dependence and other related social vices. There are a number of drugs, including but not limited to marijuana, opium, heroin, and cocaine, which are considered illegal and dangerous drugs. This law is very strict and rigid, with people found guilty of its offense facing a long imprisonment and huge fines. Nonetheless, few drugs are still permissible. Most prescription-only and over-the-counter drugs are acceptable unless they are misused and abused. Thereof, widely used and abused medications such as antibiotics, antihistamine, and analgesic, topic or oral, can be legally bought and consumed. Even carrying prescription drugs into the country has its own limitations, which is the requirement of a physician prescription as well as other necessarily papers. That would be all, sir, and thank you.